Multnomah, Past and Present. This 1925 Multnomah street scene was captured before the viaduct was built in 1927. It was taken at the corner of Capitol Highway and 35th and looking west. Here's a view of the same Multnomah location taken in the 1960s with the viaduct in place. This shot is also at the corner of Capitol Highway and 35th and looking west. These scenes of the Raz Brothers Dairy Farm are looking east and before the community of Hillsdale existed. This area is looking east at what is now Wilson High School, and Hoffman Road can be seen on the right. Looking west, we see the Multnomah Dairy on Hoffman Road, now named Vermont Street, which was the home of pioneer Henry Tandler. The Tandler home was located near the present-day Southwest Community Center at Southwest Vermont and 45th. Oregon Electric, the first railway, was built through part of what is now Southwest and West Portland. This is Multnomah's most familiar scene. The Oregon Electric built their line in 1907, with services beginning in 1908. The Multnomah station was a wooden depot, as seen on the left. This event marked the beginning of the town of Multnomah, a station name chosen by the railway. Just east of the railroad station was the Bungalow Grocery, owned by Nelson Thomas, which was housed in what many consider the first business building in Multnomah. The building became the first post office in 1912 with Thomas as postmaster. Thomas kept a typical general store, and farmers came from miles around to get supplies of all kinds. Above the store was a large hall, which was used for public entertainment and community dances. The building would shake when the train went by. Thomas had a pair of horses, Dandy and Billy, about 1,100 pounds each, which drew his covered Studebaker Deluxe delivery wagon. One day he took orders, and the next he delivered them. Thomas's store is now Marco's Restaurant at Southwest 35th and Multnomah Boulevard. This street scene is looking south on Southwest 35th Avenue. Thomas's original building was first enlarged and faced with brick and eventually moved north in 1914. The present building was built by T.E. Peer. This scene shows the building of the railroad west of Multnomah and looking to the east. Notice the fill that raised the railroad bed. This area is close to the present-day West Hills Village facility located on the north side of Multnomah Boulevard. This scene is North Main Street, Garden Home looking to the west. This is the Garden Home station with tracks on both sides. This area is now near the old Market Pub. The structure was once Whitney's Custom Cannery. One of the earliest settlers of Multnomah was Matthew Barron, who had about 5 acres just north of Thomas Grocery on the other side of what is now Capitol Highway. This picture was taken about 1914 or 1915, looking south from his property. You can see the large building put up by the Pfeiffers with a dance hall on the second floor. Matthew Barron's first home was lost in a 1926 fire, but in 1927 he built this home, which still stands today near Southwest 35th Street and Southwest Canby Street. The home featured imported tiles and stained glass features from Italy.